be able to perform in any way that they'd like. So you look through the programming, you probably see we have a nice variety of styles of music and even some poetry thrown in there. I also would like to thank some people who have helped out a lot with this show. First and foremost, Jordan Wilson and Curtis Rockwell have helped so much with the tech here. You know, we couldn't have gotten this put together without them. So I would like to thank them especially. Ishiemi as well. He is going to be performing in the first part of this, and he has helped out a lot with making the materials for our posters and our logo and just organizing things. He's been a major help to me. And also, I'll give a thanks to Will here. He's going to be our MC. So thank you all for coming out, and I hope you enjoy the show.
So for our first performance, we have Ishiemi and Frank. So we would like to welcome them for our first performance. And we're performing as the band of If.
You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. so hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
video on Spotify, hopefully in the next month or so. So if you're interested, we'll be in the news coming. So thanks so much.
Next up, we have something a little bit different. We have poetry with pun. Now, we would like you, instead of applauding, is to do snapping, just to get in the mood of poetry, you know? Alrighty, and here comes pun.
Hello, JC. I'm going to introduce myself briefly before I get started here. My name is Connor Green, also known as Green to a lot of people. I am the founder and president of the Juniata College Poetry Club, and I thought I'd share some of my work in the theme of love with you today. I'm pretty sure your programs have some kind of transcript, so follow along if you want to. But this first poem is called I Manage. I managed. My feet scraped, my knees scraped, my heart ached, my hands still violently shake, my nervous system quakes at the thought of no escape. I take a break. It's the only thing I forgot to take, the pill in the bottle along with the vodka so opaque. I managed. My brain constantly hurt, I spoke in spurts, I dropped several flirts. I felt like I was the worst, my stomach or my pancreas was bound to explode and burst. Unfortunately, me breaking would not be a first. I managed. Lectures were scary as my arms got more hairy, and when my poetry became flary, I was mostly wary. How do they skip off without a carry? Maybe I should be like Katniss, agree with myself to eat a poisonous berry, because maybe it'll be a blossoming sensation that tastes like cherry. I managed. My world and my thoughts were so Melville dreary as I found my shoes becoming weary of carrying a man who did not live care freely. My eyes then and now becoming teary over a date and a fate so terrifying and eerie. How could I get from here to cheer? I managed. It took soft, soothing arms, smooth music, and the reassurance that I was welcome. It took the kind of love we wish for in fairy tales but still can't fathom. It took a sickening amount of incense, face masks, and retail therapy. But I finally found someone who would care for me. Now, I can admit that with all this comfort I saw now being brought to fruition, my worries were no longer unfounded or within being fought or tuition. My worries lie now with the person who needed the most, me! While I love myself, I love you futilely, because before you, I just managed.
Up next, we have Austin. Now he will be performing an original song called Greek God with his guitar.
Happy in cursing.
Everyone knows that we
Why bother? Rough, thick, patchy, and eroded skin simply enveloped Matt West. His teal backpack complemented his rust overcoat, the kind you would wear for skiing. But this burly, burlap man didn't wish to be on the slopes, the alpines, not calling his name, nor whispering. Instead, he preferred the chickadee's whistling. Besides, that was a winter thing. His splintered ring on his finger acting like a dam to keep the blood from rushing and gushing out. His scrawny build made for a decently dressable mannequin. Gravel glides down the slippery slope, leaving legions of legendary pebbles to fall at the feet of the kings they prey upon. Scrumptious crumbs of scrumptious pies lead to the strawberry kisses and scrumptious goodbyes. Marigold gallops till the garment is ripped upon the burrs of nature's untrimmed beard. Ripened by this sight from afar, Matt turns to his trusted comrade, Sergeant Major Mason. It's no use. I'll never get her, Matt admits, with defeat in his voice, the very trembling words from his mumbling mouth and his mirthless mannerism maroons the moment.
Ah, you'll get her, son. But not with them shoes on. Goddamn! Looks like you stepped in the swamp. Them buggers are filthy. Better get to cleaning them, mate.
Sarge, you're not in the military anymore.
Oh, yeah. Touche. Go clean them, not maggot.
Friend. The word is friend. He said softly, drifting away from the damned spot. In the minutes, he was right. The shoes were filthy. But what was the point of spiffing up shoes that were just going to get dirty again? That night before bed, on his nightstand table, made of honest wood and with even more honest craftsmanship, you could tell by the wobble. He scraped, shined, and polished his boots before going to cut more firewood in the Alaskan peach sunrise. Marigold finds him, slumped over, doubled over onto his knees.
Hey, you're Matt, right? I've heard a lot about you from that newspaper that covers things in the Yukon. Yeah. Oh, I mean, I'm all right. A little tiredness, I must admit, but that's because I was up all night shining the shoes. Why on earth would you do that for? You're a lumberjack, ain't you?
Too impressive. Smiles were exchanged, and the rest was history.
Next up, we have Danielle with her Taylor Swift song.
Sound.
Prophecy, when I made a joke, the jester laughed at me. A queen gave a gesture to hang up that jester. And soon, I knew I'd be free. Red, then yellow, then green, and then blue. I've built a tower, and you've built one too. We formed quite a team, a little building crew. Building up piece for piece, I was falling for you. The dungeon was dank and dull and dim, and of all the characters, I related to him. I watched the next strain refrain. I say the words. Helpless, his brain finally picked by the birds. Red, then yellow, then green, and then blue. What charade, pray tell, have we gotten into? Talks of your old school days and Old Bailey Sue. How did I get grass stains on my shoe? The golden graceful hand rushed down with a pluck. Please pick me from this place, fair maiden, I am stuck. No one to perform my great tragedies for. I don't seem to put myself on stage anymore. Red, and then yellow, and then blue, and then green. We messed up the pattern, a sight so obscene. The layers of the tower grew numerous and complex. I was excited for the towers to see all the rest. The queen allowed me before them, a righteous act, I presume. I told her she was the prettiest girl in any room. She curtsied, told me her tears had been dried. Then she asked me, when's the last time you've cried? Red, and then green, and then a fist, and a wait! You tipped a tower over, but you let your own break. I wondered in the moment, what difference would it make? But letting your guard down, dear, was not a mistake. The portcullis fell and you let me heal. Gargoyles stood dumbfounded for it, they could not feel. And when the tears were falling down, how could it be true? The scarf you gave me was red, yellow, green, and then blue.
Our next up is Francesca with her song, Someone Like You, from Jack Horn.
I want to last in yesterday.
our beloved president, Luke, singing his Italian piece.
Round of applause, please.